Now that we are familiar with the special limits shown here below, we can sometimes use the special limits to determine additional limits. For number one, we are given the limit as x approaches 0 of sine 3x divided by x. Notice how this limit does resemble the special limit, the limit as x approaches 0 of sine x divided by x, which equals 1. The important thing to recognize about this limit is that as long as the input of the sine function is the same as the denominator, the limit is equal to 1. In our case, though, notice how the input into the sine function is 3x, and we only have x in the denominator, which means we need to manipulate this function so that we have 3x in the denominator. And we can do this by multiplying by 1 in the form of 3/3. This limit is equal to the limit as x approaches 0 of 3/3 times sine 3x divided by x. Notice when multiplying, we do have a denominator of 3x, but we also have this extra factor of 3 in the numerator. So let's rewrite this as the limit as x approaches 0 of 3 times sine 3x divided by 3x. Notice now the input for sine is 3x, and so is the denominator, and we can factor this 3 out and rewrite this as 3 times the limit as x approaches 0, again, of sine 3x divided by 3x. And now because the input of the sine function is 3x, and so is the denominator, this limit is equal to 1, giving us 3 times 1, which is equal to 3. Before we take a look at number 2, let's verify this graphically. Here we have the graph of f of x equals sine 3x divided by x, which is the given function. Notice as we approach x equals 0 from the left and the right, we do approach the function value 3, which is why the limit is equal to 3. For number 2, we have the limit as x approaches 0 of sine x divided by 5x. Again, this does resemble the special limit. The limit as x approaches 0 of sine x divided by x equals 1. In our case, though, notice how the input of the sine function is x, and we have a denominator of 5x. If it's helpful, we could include the coefficient of 1 for sine x. In this form, we can see we do have a factor of 1/5 here. Let's rewrite this limit as the limit as x approaches 0 of 1/5 times sine x divided by x. Notice now for this fraction, the input into the sine function is x, which is the same as a denominator. And just like we did with the limit in this form here, we can factor out the constant 1/5 and write this as 1/5 times the limit as x approaches 0 of sine x divided by x. This limit matches the special limit perfectly. This limit is equal to 1, giving us 1/5 times 1, which equals 1/5. Again, let's verify this graphically. Here we have the graph of f of x equals sine x divided by 5x. As we approach x equals 0 from the left and the right, we are approaching the function value 0.2 or 2/10, which is equal to 1/5. I hope you found this helpful.